Hi, it's Julius. Today we talk about how you can generate variable rate applications with PIX4Dfields. It is one of the more complex topics of precision farming, but also a very rewarding one. I will walk you through theory and practice in no time. Let's go! This video will cover what variable rate applications and their benefits are. We have a look at two common vegetation indices for variable rate applications, how you can use them to distribute your inputs on the field, how the whole process is done with PIX4Dfields from an index to a final prescription map ready for application. In the end, we have a brief look at an advanced method to get the most out of your maps. Variable rate application is a technology in precision farming that focuses on the automated application of agricultural inputs in variable quantities based on measured crop or soil heterogeneity. It is a skill to find the right amount at the right time at the right place. Applied for nitrogen applications, benefits range from yield increase and input savings over better harvesting conditions to less crop lodging. For the application of crop growth regulators and fungicides, a moderate yield increase and considerable amount of input savings can be achieved. Healthy and stressed plants reflect specific wavelengths of the visible and non-visible light differently. We make use of this property with optical sensors mounted on drones and satellites to gain insights in the health and nutritional status of our crops. A healthy crop absorbs the energy of blue and red light to fuel photosynthesis and to create chlorophyll, which will reflect infrared energy because of its structure. Well-fed crops reflect much more light in the infrared spectrum, while stressed, malnourished crops do not. We calculate ratios based on those crop-specific wavelengths, which we call vegetation indices in remote sensing. The NDVI is one of the most used vegetation indices for historic reasons. It uses the reflected red light in the visible and non-visible near-infrared light. As red light is eagerly absorbed by the plants to fuel photosynthesis, most of it's already absorbed by the top of the canopy, while lower levels of the canopy do not contribute much to an NDVI measurement. This effect increases within plants with more layers of leaves, like trees, or late-stage arable crops like corn and wheat. That is what is known as saturation of the NDVI, and limits its usefulness for variable rate applications to less dense crops or early in the growing season. Let's have a look at a better alternative on the next slide. The NDRE uses the red edge instead of the red wavelength, which allows it to assess all canopy levels, as it is not so strongly absorbed by the topmost layer of the canopy. It is very sensitive to different nitrogen levels of the leaves and biomass across the whole growing season. It is a good choice for variable rate applications. Values between 0.1 and 0.3 indicate low nitrogen uptake and biomass, while values bigger than 0.4 represent healthy, well-fed crops. Now that we understand vegetation indices, how can we use them to guide our application for nitrogen, crop growth regulators, or fungicides? We start as usual with the planning of the application rate for the whole field based on agronomic and economic best practices. Then we generate a vegetation index to uncover the variability of our field. Based on the on-site conditions, we select a suitable redistribution scheme for the whole field application rate. We can choose between two basic distribution schemes. The first is a Robin Hood method, where we take from the rich and give to the poor. That means for high vegetation index values, we will apply less input and vice versa for low values. For nitrogen applications, this will homogenize your crop and boost underdeveloped parts of the field if the agronomic conditions allow that. You should always take plant available water, temperature, crop health and growth stage into account. The second method is the Sheriff of Nottingham, who takes from the poor to give to the rich. That means, for high vegetation index values, we will apply more input, and vice versa for low values. This can be useful for the application of crop growth regulators and fungicides, where you want to rein in fat and healthy crops to prevent lodging or diseases. But you do not want to impair the growth of already underdeveloped parts of the field with those chemicals. It has to be said, even though both methods are opposing each other, they can be the right choice according to the agronomic conditions on site, and what worked in one season may not apply in another. Both schemes are a good baseline, as they do not change the total amount of applied product, but only redistribute it across the field. From there, you could carefully adjust the rates to save inputs by applying less when the agronomy indicates it. Now let's have a look on how to apply this knowledge in practice with PIX4Dfields, the software for applied agricultural remote sensing and precision farming. For the demonstration, I bought a German winter wheat field right before the second end dressing as an example. It is a 25 hectare field, and the wheat is in the beginning of the stem elongation growth stage. The dataset was acquired with a DJI P4M RTK at 120 meter above ground level. I already processed the dataset in PIX4Dfields. Now let's generate the NDIE index with the index tool. With the zonation tool, we now simplify the NDIE layer into zones. Select an uneven number of zones so that the zone in the middle of the list represents the average of the field. Now that we have the zones, we need to calculate the individual weights. For that, we need to choose the distribution scheme. Decide if we want to increase the variability of the distribution with a spread multiplicator. And finally, apply the formula to calculate the weights. We need the pre-planned flat weight for the whole field, the index value of the zone we are calculating the weight for, the average index value of the field, and the spread value if needed. Based on the distribution scheme, you either subtract a correction value from the flat weight or add to it. Let's look at an example. It is easier than you might think. For my wheat field, I decided with the agronomist to apply 60 kg of nitrogen for the second nitrogen dressing. And I want to homogenize my crop with a spread of 2. The average index value I take from the zone in the middle of the zone table. It is 0.3. Use an uneven amount of zones so you can easily take it from the zone in the middle. To calculate the weight for the red zone, I input its index value, together with the flat weight, the average index value, and the spread into the formula. The result is 72 kg of nitrogen per hectare. The middle zone always gets the flat weight, and for the yellow zone, I apply the formula again, with the result of 52 kg of nitrogen per hectare. Now I type in the respective weights. The total applied amount stays the same, and I redistributed my flat weight as variable weight. Via the export menu, zonations, I can export the zonation as a prescription map shapefile compatible with the most weight controllers. Finally, I want to mention an advanced method where you can actually save inputs instead of just redistributing them. To do that, you would designate scouting annotations in the zonation for sampling with either an end sensor or tissue sampling. Via the built-in share-to-cloud function of PIX4Dfields, you can transfer those annotations to your smartphone to find the exact location for sampling in the field. With the sampling results, you would know the exact amounts to apply in every zone according to the need of your crop. And that's all for today. For more videos like that, please subscribe to our channel. If you'd like to discuss this topic with us, head over to our community section. You can find the link in the video description below. See you next time!